Hi guys, I'm Rahul and welcome back to Fwrapper Aqua. So this video, as the title says, is called How to Quarantine Discus. So I haven't picked up fish in a very long time because I had lots of them which were breeding at my place. So a lot of you guys were asking me about how to set up a quarantine tank or get new discus, what to do once you get new fish and stuff like that. So I thought, okay, let's pick up some fish. So I picked up about six discus. So how I set up the tank, things what you need when you get a new fish. So stuff like that, that's what this video is all about. So stay tuned. This is my quarantine tank. So I'm just cleaning up before my new fishes come in. Plan to get some reds. I'm just making the tank ready for them. Just put some potassium permanganate. Letting it be for some time. Tank is set in my rack. I'm going to let it dry for some time and then I'm going to be adding some water. So for quarantine, actually you need a cycled tank. So my quarantine tank is currently here, which is cleaned out. So I'm going to be taking out about, I'm doing a water change for my blue diamond and checkerboard tank. So I'll be using the water from this tank, about 50% of the water for my quarantine tank. I will be taking from my blue diamond tank. So it's a cycled water, so then we won't have too much of issues. So when you have an existing discus tank, it's very easy to quarantine, I mean to get water to the right condition. So when you don't have a discus tank, if you're starting off fresh, then obviously you need to run your sponge filter for some time, and so that the beneficial bacteria gets built up. I'm straight away going to be adding this water into the quarantine tank. Oh, I forgot I had lights for this tank. Let's get that plugged in. Yep. Now the tank looks nice and bright. Time to add some fresh water, which is aged water from my storage tank. So some must-haves in a quarantine tank. Okay, this is like a basic temperature indicator available on Amazon and stuff, so we need to add this into the tank. Temperature handling in discus tanks is very important, and the next major thing is the TDS. This is something every discus keeper should have. It's called a TDS meter. Basically it calculates the total dissolved solids in water. So an ideal TDS for any discus is between 150 to 200. Another important thing in quarantine tank is the heater. Currently I won't be switching it on, but anyway I'm connecting it in. So next thing which is very important in a quarantine tank is aeration. So I'm going to be adding this air stone into the air pump. This is a good quality air stone which is available these days. It's made of plastic, so it lasts very long compared to the normal air stones, like which are made of stone. These actually kind of wears out after some time, so these actually last much longer, so these are much better. So now it's time to put some aeration into my tank. So that is it for starters. The tank is kind of ready, so let's go get some fish. Thank you. This a batch of mandarins, red mandarins discus, which be taking about 6 to 8 of them. And yeah, I'm gonna quarantine them. It's nice. They're all a little stressed because they just came out of the box yesterday. Some good ones. Finally, my fish has arrived. I picked up about 6 from that batch of red mandarins. Hopefully, they like their new home. So, I'm gonna slowly acclimate them by adding a little bit of the tank water. And also, I'm gonna be checking the TDS. So, let's see. So, TDS in my tank currently is about 110. Which is pretty okay. TDS in the tank, in the water which they have come in is about 255. So I need to slowly add some water from my tank into that to get the temperature to get the TDS to the similar level. But TDS of 255 is still okay. So they won't feel much of a difference because there's much better water they're going to get into. They will be stressed for a couple of days and they should be fine. Now let's slowly add them into their new home. They all are pretty stressed out because they've been in the cover for some time. Yeah, baby, welcome to your new home. Small net. Some time to get used to their new place, and I know the light is on, so I'll be switching off the light soon. So this tank will not have light for some time till they get used to the entire setup. I would preferably leave them in the dark as much as I can till they get used to the place and the water, the food, the environment entirely. Otherwise, you know, discus generally gets stressed really fast. So, you know, switching on the lights and things like that always stress out discus. So this just like switched on the lights just for the video. So once the video is done, I'll be switching the lights off. So it's 5, last boy, come on. Let's go to your new home, bro. So that's my 6 red mandarins. So hopefully they liked it there in the new house. So I'm going to be adding in filtration in a day or two. So currently only aeration, and the temperature looks fine. They're moving around, so they're not hurt or something. So let's look at them after a couple of days. Welcome, guys. I'm just adding a little bit, maybe a handful of rock salt, which is non-iodized, basically just to increase the TDS a little bit, because you know there is a difference in the TDS, and it's also kind of a first round of any kind of treatment or immunity increase is there always with rock salt. And it is a normal rock salt which you get from the local store, not your iodized what you get in the packets. It's a normal rock salt what you get. Please be very careful with that. These guys seem to be okay. They're moving around pretty active. It's just the first day, so let's hope they like their new home. Pretty active, moving around, very happy. The color is a little pale, but you can see their shape and fins are all fine. All this is because of stress. You can see slight peppering on the face. But otherwise they are moving active. It's a very good sign. So hopefully they like it here. Let's see after a couple of days how they're doing. I'm going to give them a little bit of Hikari Bio Gold. Let's see if they take it. I don't know, I'm not really sure. No, so I think they'll take some time. So feeding on the first day is generally not advisable. But anyway, let's see, they should take it. It's about a week now since I got these guys. They're okay now, they're eating. Very little though, but yeah, they'll take some more time. Time to do some water change. I'm just finishing up water change in my other tank. So always better to do water change in your quarantine tank in the last. So you don't mix up. Time to do some water change. So I use a completely separate siphon for a quarantine tank. I don't mix up my regular siphons with quarantine tank. As you can see, they've been eating, they've been shitting, so that's good. So that is a good sign. Yeah, this little bit of waste, which is good. That means they are eating food what is given to them. So I'm planning to do like about 40% water change for them. Basically remove out any excess waste and food. They look pretty okay. Water is a little cold. I think we need to switch on the heater a little bit. Yeah, so the good sign is that they are not pooping white. So there's black poop only. So there's no white poop. And yeah, they look pretty okay. Time for some fresh water. Any fish, or like discus or any fish for that matter, they just love when water change is done. They feel really good once water change is done. Like most of my fishes just enjoy it after water change. These guys also will get used to it. Just as it takes some time. If you see these guys, they just love it. Anyways. After water change, I use this product called Stress Heal from Aquatic Remedies. A lot of people say it's not a great product, but I haven't had any issues. So 5 to 10 ml for about 100 liters. So this holds about 50 liters. So I'm just going to be dropping in some few mls into this. So basically Stress Heal, there are a lot of other products which are available. Basically it helps in relieving the stress. If there are some wounds in the fish, it helps in that. And especially when you have a new fish, it's good to have similar products. You have sea cam products too. So this is something which I bought some time back, and when I had when I was buying fishes before. So I bought these fishes after about 1.5 years now, because I had a lot of fishes which were born in my aquarium itself, so I didn't buy fishes from outside. So this is about this is the batch I bought after about 1.5 years now. So yeah, so this product has been good. I mean, they're pretty much okay now, they're responding. Let's give them some food and see how it goes. This is Australian blackworms. It's one of the best food what I mean, Discus just love these food. So I'll just try and fix this onto the glass. So if they like it, they will definitely come and have it. Scared right now, but they should respond. Let's hope. So you can see they're slowly coming towards the food. So that's a very good sign. Yeah, they like it. So yeah, the six red fishes which I got are pretty good. They're okay, they're responding to food. So this is basically a few of the steps that you need to keep in mind when you buy new fish. You keep them happy and they always respond. So a few things that you guys need to really take care. As you can see, all the six are eating well. So it's a very good sign. So they're going to be in this tank for another month or so. So generally a quarantine, ideal quarantine process is about 90 days. So till then you don't put them into your main tank. So I'm planning to keep them in this tank for about 2 months. And yeah, then if they all do well, then they go into the big tank which I plan to make. So as of now, they all love. They all like the new place. Slowly you can see the color is also coming back to normal. So they should get their color back soon. They seem to be happy. Good. This guy is a good one. Nice red. Yeah, all of these guys will get that color, yes. Yeah. Good food, fresh water. That's the only thing, only key to keeping Discus or any other fish. Do your regular water changes and just give them good food. Remove the waste every day. Keep the water clean. And definitely these guys, any fish you buy will be happy. This is like the second week they are in my house. They are all a little stressed because of water change. Yeah. So it's good to do about weekly 2 times of water change for Discus. So I'll soon be feeding them and they will be fine. This is the most important thing. Any fish, if they are happy, they'll eat well, they'll be very active. This is the only thing we need to see when you buy new fish, and this is a good sign. They're happy in their new tank. Yeah, any fish gets a little stressed when you do water change. So yeah, a few of them, the colors have come back. And yeah, so this is all we need to do when you get a new fish. So it's a very simple process. Clean water and good food, that's about it. I always say that, yeah. So hope you guys liked the video. If you did, please do like and share our video, and please do support us by subscribing to our channel if you haven't subscribed yet. So a lot of new videos coming up. Next video is about humidity levels. If you have too many tanks, like I have about 8 tanks in my house, the humidity levels in the house kind of goes up. So I bought kind of a lot of small things to just keep a check on it and how to kind of somehow try and bring that down. That's something which is coming up next. The tank which is right behind me had a small leak, so I had to do some small jugaad and some kind of fix without kind of emptying the tank. I have somehow fixed it, touch wood, it's been working. So stuff like that. So small new stuff, tips which I try to share, which are from our experiences of keeping fish. So like I always say, fish keeping and plant keeping is really fun if you do it the right way. Yeah, so cheers guys.